Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand. I am tired.
Alexandria deeply regrets the actions and inactions of our white forebearers, and on September 24th in the year 2022 acknowledges the terror experienced by McCoy, Thomas, and the African-American members of this community. And we recognize these two men whose legal rights were thwarted, to whom justice was denied, and who lost their lives to racial hatred. And we apologize to Joseph McCoy, Benjamin Thomas, to their families, and to the black community posthumously. And whereas this Alexandria soil represents the lives of McCoy and Thomas, as well as the heritage and accomplishments of the African-American members of this community. And whereas, as such, this soil is sacred to us. And whereas Alexandria citizens will carry this hallowed soil to a final resting place at the National Memorial for Peace and Justice in Montgomery, Alabama, to bring peace to the souls of McCoy and Thomas, and to the community of Alexandria. And upon our return from this pilgrimage, this city will continue to lay bare past and present inequities, to expose our troubled racial history, and to bear witness to these atrocities. Alexandria is committed to reconciliation, so our community emerges stronger and more inclusive. In this way, the deaths of Joseph McCoy and Benjamin Thomas will never be forgotten.
Everything that we saw it down in Selma was great. I have a problem with my knees. I was so worried that I wouldn't be able to walk across the Pettus Bridge because of that. I want to start out by saying I was the third person. They let the people with problems go first, and I was the third person to cross that bridge. I've been wanting to do that for years. But what I liked and what I got from that trip more, it ended with, we went on a pilgrimage. We came back with relationships.
I feel as though it's difficult confronting the past in a way where we have to live in a society where we're not told the past, you know, from birth to, you know, however old we are now, because in our school system, and I like to bring this up very often, they don't teach us this. They do not tell us anything regardless of it. We could study African Americans for like, what, a week, maybe even a couple of days if we're lucky, and then after that, it's on to the next unit. However, there's a complexity to it, and it's a very important subject that we actually need to dive deep into and debunk because of what was going on and how much of it was happening. And that's why I'd like to like just say that this trip was a monumental discovery for me.
Past year, I can't even talk about that either. It went beyond our wildest dreams, and I prayed that we would have a program worthy of Dr. King and the city's 50th anniversary. It was at the Masonic Temple. I understand that the temple has 375 seats or something, but we had to put chairs in the aisle because we wanted to reach out. This, and part, it came from this pilgrimage that we went on. There's so many people. For many years, our program has been mainly held at Black churches, very few white churches, and the main of our audience has been African-Americans coming to honor Dr. King. And I just felt that everyone needed to know. The people from the pilgrimage also got their friends to help us with the program. They got involved with the program. And I cried through the first three verses of Lift Every Voice and Sing because it was just wonderful. The program itself, the people that came, and it was really just love between the people in that building.
Like watching the documentary, like for the first time, it was crazy because, you know, the emotions that I felt there, I still feel it now. Like it's still there. And it's like reliving the trip over and over again. Like I wouldn't want anything else in the world except for going on that trip again, because we've grown together as, you know, not just classmates, but like we're like family. And, you know, going through the same experiences, although we felt differently about it, that's what brought us together. And even answering the questions during the documentary, we kind of just wanted to make sure that, you know, what we learned is, you know, without a doubt, something that we needed to learn a long time ago. And now that we've gained this information, it's time that we continue that research, and not only continue that research, but to pass it on.
Yeah.